At a depth of about 4 millimeters from the occlusal surface, I do begin to see the pulp horns. For this case, we have a patient that has a chief complaint of thermal and pressure sensitivity in the lower right quadrant. Our examination reveals severe occlusal decay on 31. The plan is to perform a caries cleanout and a direct camouflage composite restoration. The objective for any caries removal is to first identify the extent of the decay. Here I'm using a medium grit round and tapered diamond to extend the preparation in all directions until I locate uninfected DEJ. You are able to use any gross reduction burr of your choice. Because I'm focused on the DEJ initially, I only have the burr extend to a depth of about 2 millimeters. Once a clean DEJ ring around the prep is achieved, I complete the rest of the caries removal with a slow speed round burr along the axial walls while with light pressure, carefully advance apically. I like to use caries indicator dye as an aid to help guide where demineralized tooth structure is, but keep in mind there may also be false positives. I see that there's a crack line through the distal marginal ridge, but since there isn't any signs of leakage or decalcification, I like to bond directly to these areas. At a depth of about 4 millimeters from the occlusal surface, I do begin to see the pulp horns. It's best to leave any affected dentin to avoid pulpal irritation and further complications. At this depth, I condition the cavity with polyacrylic acid for 20 seconds and then apply gluma for a minute.